Dear students, in this lecture, we are going to see the various topics that are all covered there in the Unit 2. So, in this Unit 2, we are going to see what is meant by DNA replication. Then, what are the various models that explains about the DNA replication, which includes conservative model, semi-conservative and dispersive model. In these three models, through experiments, it has been confirmed as a semi-conservative method is the one in which the DNA is replicating. For that only, they have conducted an experiment called as a Michelson and Stahl experiment. And the next one, we are going to see the different kinds of replication, such as a theta structure of replication or bidirectional replication or Keynes model of replication. And the other one is a rolling circle replication, which is also referred as a sigma replication or unidirectional replication that commonly takes place in certain DNA viruses, bacteriophage and some circular RNA viruses. And then we are going to see what is the linear replication process that takes place in the virus also. Then we come into the steps that are involved in the DNA replication, especially in the prokaryotic organisms. As this molecular biology course totally covers with the molecular biological events that have been associated there with the bacteria. So, importance will be given there for a prokaryotic related technical things. Say, prokaryotic transcription, prokaryotic replication, these are the things will be covered in the subsequent classes also. The next one is, what are the various enzymes and proteins that have been involved there in the replication? A lot of various enzymes and their own special kind of a protein that is called as a single strand binding protein. These are all involved there in the replication. And these proteins are complexing together and they form into some special structures such as a replisome, pre-primosome, primosome. These are all we are going to see in detail. And finally, what is the method by which the semi-conservative replication is taking place there on the living organisms? It is commonly referred as a semi-discontinuous replication. That is, it is not continuous. One strand of DNA will be synthesized continuous, whereas the other strand of DNA will be synthesized in a discontinuous manner. And that leads to the formation of the Okazaki fragments. And in the future lecture, we will try to see what is the Okazaki fragments and what is its importance there with reference to the replication process. Next, we look at the DNA replication. This DNA replication is a very important process there in the cell reproduction. That is, after the complete replication of the DNA molecule only, it will be separated and it will be passed on to the next generation cells. So, during the process of DNA replication, two parental strands separate. So, you can able to see here in the right hand side, two parental strands are getting separated. And this separated strand, each acts as a template to direct the enzyme catalyzed synthesis of a complementary daughter strand following the normal base pairing rule. So, they are getting separated. As a result, each strand is serving as a template on which a new strand has been builded. You can look at the dark black color new strand that have been formed by an enzyme catalyzed reaction, that is through the DNA polymerase enzyme, and with the complementary strand formed with the help of the base pairing rules. Say for example, if you look at in the parental strand, if G is present, then in the daughter strand, it will be automatically C. If it is C there in the parental strand, the daughter strand will be having the G. So, this normal base pairing rule is fully adopted there during the process of replication of the two parental strands. The new double-stranded molecule then passes on to the two daughter cells during the process of cell division. In the right hand side, you can able to see two double stranded molecule. So one is the conserved parental strand, another is a newly formed daughter strand. This is the reason why the replication is referred as a semi-conservative model of replication. So after the formation of two double stranded molecules, those particular DNA will be passed on to the two daughter cells that will be usually formed after the end of the cell division. Next, we look at some specific structures. Say for example, what is replication fork? The point at which separation of two strands and synthesis of a new DNA will be taking place. That particular location is referred as replication fork. The replication fork will be always asymmetric in nature. And as I already narrated, the type of replication which takes place in the living organism is of mainly semi-conservative in nature, meaning one parental strand is conserved there in each daughter cells. That is one parental strand and a daughter strand. They enter into a one daughter cell. So the parental strand is conserved. That is the reason it is referred as a that is partly conserved. That is the reason it is referred as a semi-conservative DNA replication. Next, we look at into the various models of DNA replication. So currently there are three models of DNA replication has been available. One is the conservative model, another one is a semi-conservative model, and third one is a dispersive model. These are the three models that explains about how a DNA may be replicated. First, we look at into the conservative model. In this model, two parental DNA strands are back together after replication is completed. That is, the two parental strands are backed into one cell and the newly formed daughter strand is backed into the other newly formed cell during the process of replication. So here, one daughter cell contains both parental strands. That is the one that have been shown in a dark blue color lines. So these dark blue color lines indicates the one daughter cell which entirely receives the parental DNA strand. However, if you look at into the other daughter cell, it is receiving the DNA strands that have been newly synthesized during the process of replication. This has been shown in the light blue color lines. So here the DNA after replication, it has been completely conserved there in the newly formed cell. That is, parental strand is conserved in one daughter cell and the newly synthesized strand is conserved in another daughter cell. The next model of DNA replication is a semi-conservative replication. This semi-conservative replication is the one which commonly taking place there on the living organisms. Here, as per this model, the two parental strands separate during the process of replication and each strand further serves as a template for the synthesis or the formation of the new strand. And the new strand that has been formed will be conserved there with the old strand. So this can be easily visualized there in this diagram. That is, in the two DNA double helix that have been shown there, one strand is made up of the parental strand that is shown in the dark blue color. The other strand is a newly synthesized strand that is shown in the light blue color. Thus, in a cell, both the parental as well as newly synthesized DNA strands were conserved. Or in other words, the parental strand is conserved over the generation of the cells. The third form of DNA replication is referred as a dispersive model of the DNA replication. In this dispersive model of DNA replication, the integrity of the parental strands have been completely broken and they are dispersed. That is the reason it is referred as a dispersive model of DNA replication. So, as per this model, the parental double helix strand is broken into double stranded DNA segments. So, you can able to see the parental strand is broken into double stranded small piece of segments and they are interspersed during the course of replication. So, here this model is different from the conservative as a semi-conservative model, and the newly synthesized strand as well as the parental strands are dispersed together and they are further transmitted to the other generation. So, here the parental strand, as like the previous models, acts as a template for the synthesis of new double helix molecule. The segments then reassemble into a complete DNA helices, each with parental, that is a dark blue color shown strand, as well as the daughter or the progeny strand, that is shown in the light blue color segments, DNA segments that have been completely interspersed together during the course of the replication. And this model of replication is referred as a dispersive model of DNA replication. However, in the living organism, mainly the DNA replicates through semi-conservative model.